Alright guys, in this video I am going to be showing you how to make a Minecraft bucket server. So there will be links down in the description to all of the websites that I'm using in this tutorial. So first of all, you have to go to this site, getbukkit.org. And if you scroll down on the site, you can see all these different download links to different versions. But for this tutorial, I'm going to be using 1.10.2. as you see here in the top left corner. So let's click download on that one, and it'll take us to the like an ad, and you'll just have to wait the 5 seconds and click on the yellow button up in the right hand corner. I'm not gonna do that, but I will show you the next step in just a second. So once we're out here on the desktop, I opened this one. I've called it tutorial, YouTube tutorial, because it's for this tutorial, right? Okay, good enough. All right, so this is the thing that we downloaded from the page before. And you just want to save it in a folder where you want the server to be, because it's going to create a lot of files. So next, you're going to make a text document, and doesn't matter what it's called. Just call it anything. Open it, go up to file, go to save as, and call it something like start.bat or anything. It's the one that you're gonna run every time you want to start a server. Then down here, we're going to choose all files and save it. So down in the description, you can find what I'm pasting in here. So once you've found this down in the description, you just wanna put it in here. And this number right here, it means that it uses 4 gigabyte of your RAM. So if you want to use either more or less, you can change the number by just, I can put the different numbers down in the description, so you can see what is for 1 gigabyte and 2 gigabytes and 4 and 6 and up all the way up to 16 or something. But on my computer, I have 16 gigabytes. And if you have, so actually, if you don't know how much RAM you're having on your computer, then you can go down here in the left corner, right click, click on systems, and it'll take you to this page or window here where you can see right in the middle, it says installed memory RAM. And I have 16 gigabytes on my computer. And from what it says on your computer, you only want to dedicate half of the RAM for the server or less. So I've chosen 4 gigabytes, but I should be able to go all the way up to 8. So if you have 8 gigabytes, then you should only dedicate 4 or less. Alright, so now that we're back to this one, we can just close it and go ahead and start it up. Remember to start the bat file instead of the instead of clicking on the craftbukkit.jar file. We'll just wait for it to load here. Okay, so now it says we have to agree to some ELUA thing there. And you just double click on this one and set it to true. And if you want to read about it, you can go to this website up there with Mojang. But I mean, who wants to read that? Just say true and start up the server again. So we're waiting once again. And you can see it crafts all of these different things in here. Files and folders and server properties. And now there comes a lot more. We'll just check here, and it is creating a world. So this can actually take a little bit of time, and I'm just gonna cut right to it. So once it's finished creating all these files, you wanna type in stop and click enter. It saved the worlds, and you can just click any button to close that. Now you can see we have all these new folders and files and stuff like that. So if you wanna go to the one with server properties and right-click it and click open with Notepad++. And if you don't have that one, I will link it in the description so you can download it. So in here we can find all sorts of things where you can like allow the Nether to be open, so you can go there. You can select the level name, like what the world is going to be called, whether you can fly or not. I think it's just gonna kick you if you set it to true and you're flying around. There's going to be the server port, there's going to be, if you want a special seed to be generated as a world, the server IP. I'm going to come into that like more in a second on how to set that up. Oh, we have whitelists, so that is if you want some people to not be able to join, or some specific people to be able to join, actually, rather. You put them in the whitelist folder out here, right down there. You can just click edit on that one as well. So you put on everybody that should be able to get in on your server, and they'll have access. So there's about PvP and difficulty. You can set that from 0 to 2. Yeah, 0 to 2. And that'll be from peaceful and all the way up to hard. Whether or not you want to have command blocks in here. It's actually one I want to set to true, because like you can't get it unless you own the server. So view distance, I always set that to 8, just because like most of the time you don't need to see anywhere like for that far. And the server uses a lot more RAM, the more that everybody on the server can see. You can set how many people you want on the server as well, whether you want to spawn monsters or not, generate structures, and you can set all sorts of things. You can like look at the list and see what you want or not. And this last one, that's actually just what it's going to say under your server down inside of Minecraft. You can say like, hello YouTube, and I'll show you where it says it in a second. So once you're done in this settings folder, you can just close it, like save it and close it. And we'll start up the server, and I've already started up Minecraft, as you can see down here. We'll just wait a second here, see if it loads it correctly. Alright, it's preparing the spawn area. So after it has generated all the worlds, it's going to be much faster and easier to start it up. Or the next time you're gonna boot it up. So we go on a multiplayer, and you can see I've already put it in here, but the way you want to add a server is just give a name to it, and then down here in the search folder you put in cmd. You open one of those and place ipconfig, and right here you can see that's my IP. So that's the one I'm gonna log in with. Where's Minecraft? There's Minecraft. So I want to put in that right here. And that was 5. So that's actually what you do. You click done. And you can see that's where it says hello YouTube. Delete that one again. You can see that's where it says hello YouTube S. So whatever we put in that text file down in the bottom, that's what it's going to say right here. So we can join the server. And let's see right here. So one of the first things you want to do when you start in your new server here is go back into this one and place, click in here. You want to say OP and then the name of your character. And that's just for you getting all the rights. You're going to be a administrator in here, so you can like change game mode and stuff. If I want to go creative, I can do that. I couldn't do that before. This is actually a nice little world. Wow. Like a survival world here. It's pretty cool. Alright, but anyways, that was mostly it for this tutorial. And I'll probably come up with a new video about how to install plugins and how to use them later. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.
It just starts off with you getting to pick a Pokemon like
Pikachu,
Charmander,
Squirtle.
Let's see, let's pick ourselves a Charmander. And